Good morning everyone. Today in chapter 3 human development we will have a brief discussion related to the human development of India. India with the population of over more than 1.2 billion 120 million right is ranked 131 among the total 188 countries in 2016. And at that time, we had a composite HDI value 0.624. And as per this, we falls in the medium human development index. With this composite value of 0.624, India find itself in the group of country which shows medium human development. If we compare with the other countries of the world, you may have a look on table 3.1, which shows the human development index value of India and other countries. When we find India is here at 131st rank with the composite index value of 0.624. On other hand, almost the Norway, Germany, UK, Russia, all European countries are in higher value. As well, the USA is in higher HDI value. Even if we compare with the developing country, Malaysia, Sri Lanka, Brazil, China, Egypt, Indonesia, South Africa are performing better than India. We are at 131st place. It means we are not in good position after more than 70 years of independence with this current composite HDI value. With this current level of human development index, India are in extremely low group countries. There are many reasons for that. For the low score, for the low reason for the low HDI score is a very serious concern. And the reason which have been expressed is here are different, but we can categorize into two reasons. One is historical factors, another is socio-cultural factor. Historical factor, which includes the lack imperialism and the colonization. When it's come to the social culture factor, there are several regions which are related to society and a culture. This is relate. One is the violation of human right in India, especially against on the basis of race, religion, gender and caste. There are many social problems apart from that, like crime, terrorism, war, political factor, like the nature of state, form of government, level of empowerment are some of the major factor that are responsible for the low level of HDI score in India. And these all are crucial in determining the nature of human development for any country. But in these two field, we are in poor condition. And these aspects became very significant in case of developing countries like India. It's not like that we had not performed. India has always had a low level of human development due to the many problem, other problem like finance, education, gender inequality and other. And these all things have caused many detrimental and concerning effort on India's society, which include the infamous slums of India that are living under poor condition and struggling conditions to even live in comparison to the wealthy Indians that are well off. To solve all these problems, it is imperative that the causes of these problems are investigated first. but there are many other factors which are detrimental to the growth of our country. In India, according to UNDP, who calculate the HDS score of scores of different countries and give ranked on the basis of HDS score, in India itself, we have some way to calculate the HDI, and we use the different indicator of UNDP like education, health, and income. These three indicator, like any other country, we give very importance to calculate the HDI. We have a planning commission. Nowadays, this have been named as Niti Aayog, which prepared the human development report for country, for whole India, which use states and UDI as a unit of analysis. Subsequently, each of the state prepare their report on collective district level basis. All the state government prepare the state level human development report using the district as a unit of analysis, and the final human development index or human development report is published by Planning Commission of India by including these three indicators: education, health, and income. And in this report of India, we also discuss about the economic attainment, social empowerment, social distributive justice, accessibility, hygiene, and various welfare measures taken by the state government as well as the central government. Thank you.